Have you ever heard the term zeros when discussing functions? What exactly is a zero? A real zero of a polynomial function is a real number c such that f of c is equal to zero. This means when we input the real number c into the function, the output is zero. Graphically, the real zeros of a polynomial function correspond to the x-intercepts. As we can see on this graph, the x-intercept has a y-coordinate of zero. So how do we find the zeros without the graph? To find the zeros algebraically, we want to find input values that result in an output value of zero. Therefore, we set the function equal to zero and solve. Let's try an example. Find the real zeros of the function f of x equals x cubed plus 2x squared. First, we set the function equal to zero. Then we try to factor. Remember, not all polynomials will be factorable. However, we have other strategies to help us find the zeros. In this example, we will focus on factoring. We can factor out an x squared, which is the greatest common factor, giving us x squared times x plus 2. Now we can set each factor equal to 0. So we get x squared equals 0 and x plus 2 equals 0. Next, we solve for x. X squared equal to 0, we can take the square root on both sides, so we end up with x equals 0. For x plus 2 equal to 0, we can subtract 2 on both sides, giving us x equals negative 2. These are the real zeros of our polynomial function. Here is the graph. As we can see, our zeros are represented with the x-intercepts at x equals 0 and x equals negative 2.